ज्योग्राफी ऑफ इंडिया इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ वर्ल्ड ज्योग्राफी. देयर आर टू पेपर्स इन ऑल द सब्जेक्ट्स फॉर UPSC एंड द प्रोविंशियल सर्विसेज. लाइकवाइज द ज्योग्राफी ऑफ वर्ल्ड इज़ फर्स्ट पेपर एंड ज्योग्राफी ऑफ इंडिया इज़ द सेकेंड पेपर. एंड हियर यू आर सीइंग दैट द इंडिया लाइज to the north of equator, and there are two papers. In first paper we study geography of world, especially the theoretical part. For example, plate tectonics of the world is studied with global perspective. In the same way, world tropical cyclones are studied, especially the theoretical part with respect to world. But with respect to India, we revise those theoretical aspects of plate tectonic, tropical cyclone and others with reference to the India. That's why the world is the platform where theoretical aspect is covered, but with reference to India, we cover its applied aspect or application, and application is difficult than the theory. That's why in civil services the world geography or first paper is more scoring than the second paper geography of India, because here applied knowledge is required. And geography of India is very important part of geography. Why? Because we are living in India, and regional geography of India contains more matter, and its application with respect to environmental and socio-economic aspect is more important for us. But for the students of other world countries, the knowledge of those countries is necessary for those students. For example, for the student of Canada, the regional geography of Canada is more important than the geography of India. That's why there are two papers for all the students of world in their respective civil service examination. All the students of world, maybe from Germany, Japan, China, have two papers. Number one, first paper, geography of world, and second paper, geography of their respective countries. For Indian students, it is geography of India, where we have to study with the regional approach. There are two approaches to study geography. First is systematic geography of the world, wherein we cover its physical aspect and then human aspect. Likewise, in the geography of India, there are two approaches. One, systematic geography of India, wherein we cover the physical setting or physical aspect of geography of India. And the second aspect is its human and economic geography. But the second approach is the regional geography of India, wherein we divide India, political unit, in different regions. Those regions may be based on physiography, drainage, climate, human, political, economic. Thus, there are two approaches, but here we will follow the first approach, means the systematic geography of India. While studying all the chapters like physical geography of India, we will divide India into regions on the basis of physical characters. Thus, this is the system to be followed by the student for the preparation of civil services. And now we have to see the importance of geography of India or introduction. Here we have to see that India is located in North Hemisphere, in East Hemisphere. Now it will be decided later on that India is located in which hemisphere. Likewise, structurally or geophysically, if we minutely observe India, India is made up of the two lands, one from Gondwana land and other from the Angara land. In the world, India is only the country having the structure from Gondwana and Angara land. Geologically, India was part of Africa, but geographically, it is now part of Asia. So, this is the structural uniqueness of India, which no other country has. Topographically, India is again unique. If on one side there are lofty snow-clad mountains, on the other side there is plateau, plain, coastal plain, desert, all these topographies are found here. Climatically, India is country of young sun. Although there are other countries of young sun located on Cancer and Capricorn, but India has some uniqueness climatically because here is very clear seasonal variation. In all seasons, the climate is characterized with the equatorial climate to the polar climate. Because in Kerala, if there is equatorial type climate, in Jammu and Kashmir, polar and subpolar, tundra and taiga, climatic characteristics are also found. In the same way, there is pedological variation starting from laterite soil in equatorial region to the tundra and taiga podzolic soil in the high latitude region. Biotically, India is also unique, having all the biotic characteristics from equator to the polar region. Due to these physical diversities, there is human diversity also, because people from all over world are found here, having different notions, different ideas, religions and political ideologies. That's why here is different type of agriculture, different types of industries, transport, trade, political ideology, cultures, all are found here. That's why we are lucky to born here in India, because if we travel India, we can have a glimpse of the world in all respects, maybe physical, economic, social, cultural. Thus, this geography of India is very unique and attractive. Here, the next point is why to study geography of India. The answer of why is there one question, why we are born here in India. We could have got birth in Canada, in Australia, in Brazil, in Africa. Why we are born here? It cannot be answered with any scientific or physical logic. Rather, we have to go in the metaphysical ideology. And in Gita, it has been mentioned that the man gets birth, what he thinks at the end of life. What he will think at the end of life, he will think only the things in which he is involved, place where he is involved. If he is industrialist in India, he is serviceman in India, politician in India, his attachment will be with India, and that will force him to take next birth in India. In Gita, Lord Krishna preached, Arjun, Yoyam smaran bhavam tyajatyante kalevaram tam tamevaiti kaunteya sada tad bhava bhavita. O Arjun, the man leaves this body at the end having some ideas, and that's why that man gets next life according to that attachment. Okay, it is not a matter of debate here at this moment. Rather, we are born here. That's why it is our motherland. And we have to study motherland because our body is made up of this motherland India. In our body, there are five elements. Some from lithosphere means calcium, potassium, magnesium, etc. Some from hydrosphere. We are containing water not from Canadian land, not from Japan. Rather, this water is from India. Next is from atmosphere. All the air that our body has is from Indian climate, not from Brazilian climate. Wind. Wind means we are breathing in, breathing out different gases which belong to India. That's why India is our motherland. Then, whatsoever food we are taking, we are getting calcium, all these through plants and animals, through veg and non-veg system. Thus, all these five elements we have in our body, wherein this soul, this spirit resides, are from India. We are nourished by the things from India, and thus India is our motherland. Virtually, this planet Earth is Mother Earth, but its all parts, countries, are motherland for those people. India is our motherland. Japan is the motherland for Japanese. Germany is the motherland for Germans. And that's why we have to respect our mother, India. But we have not to discard the other's mother. May our mother be very much beautiful, and the other's mother may not be so much beautiful. But that mother is mother for that people. Thus, all the mothers deserve respect. Our Mother Earth deserves respect by all people. Likewise, all the motherlands, maybe motherland of Japan, Germany, Argentina, should be respected by us all. And we Indians call our India motherland. When there is a small child that plays in the soil of India and gets nourishment, when Mother Yashoda left Lord Krishna in childhood along the bank of River Jamuna and went for taking bath, Mother Earth thought to have a glimpse of that Prabhu Almighty. Mother Earth came before Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna saluted that mother with folded hand and told Mother, although Lord Krishna, incarnation of Lord Vishnu created this earth, even then he regarded earth as a mother. In the same way, if today we see the children playing in the land, in the soil, they get some nourishment. But when they become young, old, they again need this soil, this mud on their body in naturopathy. And it is Indian soil that helps have a good health. Means if more soil or mud is used somewhere in the part of body, the pain or any type of disease is cured. When that child grows more, goes to school, then there is place. And that child is expected to have a place. India is my motherland. All the Indians are my brothers and sisters. Again, that student becomes serious. That student becomes senior. Then studies the geography of India. From primary class, this starts. And that student has to sing national song. In national song, that student or people of India sing our national song. Punjab, Sindhu, Gujarat, Maratha, Dravid, Utkal, Banga. This line shows the feeling of nationalism towards our motherland and sense of a unity or state integration. Punjab does not mean the present Punjab state in India. Rather, Punjab shows the integrated form of the land wherein this Himachal Pradesh Pepsu state was included, wherein the present Punjab of Pakistan is also included. Likewise, Sindh means the land drained by the river Indus and showing the Indus Valley civilization area. That's why for national integration and so respect to our motherland, Punjab and Sindh words have been used. Then comes this westernmost state, Gujarat, then Maratha, then Dravid means southern state, Utkal, Odisha, and then Bang. Vindh Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchal Jaladhi Tarang. Next line. Here again there is geography in our national anthem. It means Vindhyachal, then Himachal, entire Himalayan range covered with the ice. Vindh Himachal Yamuna Ganga. Yamuna means Yamuna is the main river from Indian plateau draining to the Gangetic plain. A number of tributaries of Yamuna like Chambal, Betwa, Ken, Son, etc. drain from the plateau. And the next is Ganga, representing all the rivers from the Himalayas and coming with a number of tributaries from Himalayas. That's why in song mentioned that Vindh Himachal Yamuna Ganga. And next is Uchhal Jaladhi Tarang. It means along a very long coastline of India, there is ocean, oceanic waves, providing a number of energies and resources that will be studied in geography. Thus, in national song, the geography of India is there. And in the same way, in national song, there we sing that Vande Mataram. There we say that this is motherland. And we pay respect to our motherland. Likewise, people of other community also say, people of some group sing a song that Namaste Sada Vatsale Matribhume Toya Hindu Bhume Sukham Vardhitoham. In the same way, people of some other group sing a song Ma Tujhe Salam. Thus, we all Indians salute, respect our motherland India. This is our sentiment expressed for the health betterment of India. And now that students get a job. In job, suppose succeeds for civil services. In civil services, he or she will have to serve the country from any of the states. If in state service, he or she will serve the state and the Hindi speaking belt means North India is densely populated. There is more scope of services and diversity. Thus, we do different type services in India. If we are not in service, we are in any type of business, we have to live in India. For political purposes, we have to live in India, do political activities in India. Suppose you teach in Parliament. Parliament is represented by all the states. That's why, again, if you are a politician, you will have to live in India. If you are a religious-minded man, cultural-minded man, then you will reach here in Himalayan region for tourism or religion purposes. Maybe Badrinath, Kedarnath or other religious or tourist places. You will reach here Gujarat in Dwarka Dham. You will travel in North India here in Jagannath Puri, Odisha, and you will reach in South Rameswaram. Thus, for religious purpose, India is again our motherland. For tourism purpose, for planning purpose, for resource purpose, a number of purposes are there. It means we are born here in India. We have to breathe in India. We have to perform any type of activity, service, business, industry, trade, transport, religious, political, cultural, any type of activity, India is again our workplace, motherland. Thus, we are born in India, we have to live in India, die in India. That's why India is our motherland, and for this, we have to study geography of India. Not only for sake of competition, rather, it is our natural, national responsibility to have complete knowledge of India. All aspects may be physical, may be human. Because one day we will have to depart from this planet Earth for heavenly abode. And there the Almighty Creator who has sent us here will certainly ask one question, how was your life? Then we will have to respond, this life in India was best one, because there was all types of diversities. I enjoyed it, but at the same time I maintained it. What environment I got from my ancestors, I handed over it to the coming generation. My Lord, you can see there the planet Earth and therein the India. Thus, it is our national, natural and moral responsibility to keep it as a sustainable motherland and planet. Thus, these are the points that we study the geography of India, we Indians. But very wonderful thing that any foreigner when visits the India at Delhi airport, as he reaches, he purchases a book, India Air book, and within a few hours, the foreigner studies all the points, keeps in mind, because that foreigner has to live 15 days, 1 month in India. For sake of 1 month, he keeps all the geographical, social, economic informations of India in his or her mind. But very wonderful thing that we who have to pass our complete life from childhood to old age cannot contain all the knowledge of India. It means we deviate from our moral, natural duty. These are the points which compel us to have a complete knowledge of geography of India. After discussing this point, why to study geography of India, now let us come what and how to study geography of India. What to study in geography of India, these are the chapters which we have to study. As we have discussed, in geography of India, there are two aspects. One, physical aspect, physical setting, the other, human aspect and setting. Physical aspect has been given by the nature as a platform, whereon the man has developed cultural landscape. That's why it is our duty as a geographer to study both separately as well as collectively. Now let us see which are the topics in the physical setting or physical geography of India. First is lithospheric environment of India, wherein all the topographic structural slope characteristics will be studied. Then comes atmospheric conditions, wherein the climatic conditions starting from Kerala to Kanyakumari and its monsoon characteristics will be studied in detail, as well as the climatic divisions and diversity, its cause and impact will be studied. Then it is hydrospheric variables. In hydrosphere, we see that all the hydrospheric characteristics of world are traceable here. For example, hydrosphere is found in solid state as ice, which is found here over Himalayas. Here, the surface water in the form of river, pond, lake water, subsurface water, groundwater, atmospheric moisture is also found abundantly, and saline water is found abundantly along the coastline. Thus, hydrosphere is variable and rich in India. That will be subject matter of study. Next point is pedospheric. As we have studied that all types of soils are found in India, and we will study the cause of variation in soil and its impact on socio-economic characters. Next is biospheric characteristics. As we have studied that all types of biosphere from equatorial evergreen forest to tundra is found in India, that is very interesting aspect of geographical studies. After studying these physical aspects in India, now we come to the resource, that is human aspect. The variables of these spheres may be lithospheric, atmospheric, hydrospheric, pedospheric and biospheric are resources when they are being identified by man. That's why resource is very important thing, because there is spatial or regional variation in these characteristics. And in resource, man is very valuable resource, and man is a resource because it is man who identifies, uses these resources. Thus, there is a human resource, very rich human resource, under the supervision of Human Resource Development Ministry. And there is variation in the resource in India. Next is agriculture, and agriculturally there is India is diverse. In one part, if in the northwestern part wheat is grown much, then in the eastern part it is jute, in northeastern tea, in western cotton, in south spices. These are the regional variation which have some geographical causes and some socio-economic impacts. Next is industry. Agriculture is first need of man, which provides food and nutrient. Second need is the clothing, which is being fulfilled by the cotton textile industry. Likewise, industrially, India is diverse. If in western part means Gujarat and Maharashtra, there is concentration of cotton industries, certainly in the eastern part, tea industries. In the eastern means Koilanchal area, there is iron steel industry. Thus, there are industrial variations and concentrations. It has some geographical causes and some impacts on the society of India. After studying industry, we will study the transport, communication and trade. Because when we see on the map of India that there is resource diversity, there is agricultural variation, there is industrial concentration and complexes, then certainly a map comes up in the mind that some areas have surplus agricultural industrial products and resources. Contrary to it, some areas have deficiency in these respects, like this Rajasthan and this run of Kutch Himalayan region. And for that, transportation route development is needed. This is the result that in India, there are different means of transportation, different types of transportation, maybe road, rail, air, water. And after understanding this transportation network in India, we will study the communication of people from one corner of the country to the other, and at last comes trade. Because from the resource surplus area to resource deficient area, the material is being carried as a trade. For example, tea from Assam is transported to the other part of the country. Spices from South India to the remaining states. Cotton and groundnut from Gujarat and Maharashtra to the entire country. Thus, this is also very important geographical topic of the India. Next is cultural setting. When we travel over the land of India from one place to other place, we see that culturally there is cultural diversity. On the one side, if there is Kashmiri culture, then Punjabi culture, Gujarati, and all the states have their cultural uniqueness. Thus, in India, in spite of the cultural diversity, there is unity. Next point, we will see while traveling over India that there is settlement diversity. If somewhere there are temporary settlements in desert, then certainly the settlements in Northeast India are made up of the local material, local product, means these are largely made up of wood. At the same time, in mountains, made up of stones. Thus, there is settlement diversity. If somewhere settlement is very sparse and somewhere in Himalayas, hamlet type settlement, then certainly in the Gangetic Plain, there is very compact and large settlement and villages are very dense. After understanding the cause of variation in the settlement, we will see the next topic, that is regional development and planning. After studying these aspects in India, certainly a map will emerge wherein we can observe that some areas are developed and some are backward. For example, this northern Gangetic Plain is developed agriculturally, and this eastern part, means this Koilanchal, is developed industrially. The western part is developed on the basis of agro-based industries, and the southern part also on the basis of agro-based industries. And in the Himalayan region, there are forest-based industries. This map shows that there is variation in the development, but the moral responsibility of central government is to develop, to provide the development facilities to all the citizens of India equally. But it is nature which is not allowing that. This is the reason that is the concept of regional planning development, for which Government of India has developed Desert Development Program, Dry Zone Agricultural Program, Mountain Develop or Hill Development Program, Tribal Area Development Program, Drainage Basin Area Development Program, Metropolitan Development Program, Culturable Command Area Program. We have to study all these in the development chapter and regional planning. The next topic will be political aspect. When there is study of all these aspects in geography and there is development and taking that special variation in the development, people become politician and they make most of such conditions and they lead the people of backward areas for the development plan, and for that sake they do politics. And this is the reason that there is a special variation in political ideology, which we study in this aspect. In political aspect, we have to cover two aspects. Number one, the international politics along the border, and number two, the internal politics, interstate politics or interdistrict politics. But this politics is now based on the economic ground. There are demands of the independent states and districts on the basis of agricultural aspect, on the basis of agro-socio-economic conditions. There are demands of separate states and districts, and government is bound to fulfill those. Thus, this is very current geographical topic. And at last, we will see that contemporary issues are also very important. Contemporary aspect is not an independent topic, rather it is from all the physical and human aspects. For example, if there is volcanic activity in Barren Island, it is contemporary issue from the physical aspect, and it should be studied with respect to cause and its environmental and socio-economic aspect. In contemporary issue, there may be the incidence of landslide or avalanche. That should be also studied with respect to physical environment and its repercussion on the society and economy. And if there is demand of Vidarbha, it is also contemporary issue from the political aspect. It should also be studied with cause and effect. Thus, this contemporary issue is very important, and we, while studying book, magazine, journal or newspaper or from any other source, we have to emphasize these things, firstly by having a clear knowledge of its location. If you know the location, certainly you will have a clear picture of the physical and human background of that location, and you may easily understand the cause and impact of that incidence or that contemporary incidence. Thus, these are the points or aspects These are the points we have to cover in the two geographical aspects of India. Number one, physical aspect. Number two, human and economic aspect. Now, next point is, after knowing what to study in geography of India, next point is how to study geography of India. In India, we have to study these points, and the knowledge of these aspects may be gained firstly from the literature, that is second hand knowledge. Literature may be a book, journal, magazine or newspaper, and that is a knowledge which is second hand, but our responsibility is to keep that knowledge in our mind. And if it is in our mind, then now we are full. Because there is one saying that reading makes a full man, conference ready man, and writing an exact man. That's why first you will take the book knowledge completely. And if it is in your mind, then certainly while talking, discussing with anybody, this matter will come in the discourse. And if you will discuss it, then you will become a ready man. And it is ready man, ready student who can get success in interview. And if you can have that knowledge in mind, you can speak, then certainly you can write it also exactly. That's why writing makes an exact man, and that man becomes perfect for the success in any field, that may be civil or competition. That's why your first duty is to have this book knowledge, literature, in your mind. Now, your second step is to think how this secondary knowledge came in book. Certainly, it has come from the reality, come from the nature. For example, if somebody has described geography of Himalayas, then certainly that author might have seen, done field work of the Himalayan region. That's why it is our national moral duty to have a tour of India. If some has shortage of money, then there are a number of sources to see these on televisions, YouTube, and a number of sources. And if I have watched the reality of India, you can imagine the first-hand knowledge. Thus, the first-hand knowledge from nature or reality, and the second-hand knowledge from the book, magazine, and newspaper will help you having a clear concept of geography of India. Very important point is that you are going through the book, geography literature. It is compulsory to have atlas, so that you may have location of that place in your mind. Because suppose it is Jodhpur and it has been described, then if location is clear, certainly the physical background, means this lithospheric, atmospheric, hydrospheric, pedospheric, biospheric background will be in your mind. On that basis, you can have an imagination of these things there. That's why there will be composite picture of that Jodhpur in your mind. On that basis, about regional planning, political aspect, you can have an idea. Thus, these are the ways through which you can have the knowledge of India. And if you have the knowledge of India, then certainly you are worshipping our motherland in real sense. On this video, UPSC may have a number of questions like why to study the geography of India. There may be a question on which you are expected to write 150 words. What to study in geography in India, you will give these chapters in brief and in the interlinked way. Then, how to study geography of India, this may be asked, and this you should have in your mind because this will help you learn the geography of India. Thus, these are the points about the geography of India, why to study geography of India, what to study in geography of India, and how to prepare geography of India.